Welcome to 5-Minute Pitch. I'm your host, Liz Saunders. 5-Minute Pitch is the competition that gives entrepreneurs from around the globe the opportunity to virtually pitch their business or product idea for the chance to win a grand prize of $50,000. This season, more than 30 entrepreneurs will pitch their ideas via Zoom conference call to our panel of five experts for the chance to advance to the finals and pitch to the judges live in Miami, Florida. Our panel of expert judges includes Greg Mercer, Steve Chu, Mike Jackness, and Scott Voker, all 7- and 8-figure e-commerce sellers who have run and sold multiple successful businesses. Today we are joined by guest judge Pat Flynn. Pat is a well-respected thought leader in the areas of online entrepreneurship, digital marketing, and lifestyle businesses. Today, the judges continue the semifinals deliberation to decide which four contestants will make it through to the final round filming in Miami. This round includes Click and Carry, Spinny Blocks, Party in a Box, and American Cuckoo Clock. This is 5-Minute Pitch. To start, the judges see if there is someone they can put through immediately into the finals.
If I had to choose one favorite out of this, I think I might choose Click and Carry.
And why?
Kim has made, I think, maybe a few poor decisions in the past, but I do think she has a really good product. I think she's figured that out, learned from her mistakes, and I think that can carry on to be a very successful business into the future. So I would like to see Kim in the final round. Is there anyone that can agree with me?
Yeah, I agree with you too. She's got this innovative product. It's sold 300,000 units. It's got a proven track record. She's ready to go.
And I think she has the opportunity to go back to QVC if she wanted to, although the online sales are, I think, going to pick up, especially now that she's on Prime, because she just got on there. Yeah. And I think that, you know, she's somebody who does learn from her mistakes. She's got the drive, obviously, or else she wouldn't have gotten to this point. So I agree. I think she should just be automatically moved in.
Yeah, I really love this product, and I love everything that she's done. She's a go-getter. And I think there's so much more potential that's there now that she's kind of, you know, gotten through those learning curves. So I'm a yes for her.
Okay. Click and Carry was definitely my top two coming into this bracket. I think it's an easy one to put through. So congratulations, Kim.
Congratulations, Kim. You're moving on to the finals in Miami. Now the judges will see if there is someone they can eliminate right off the bat.
This one's a harder decision for me. On one hand, I've got kids and I really see Spinny Blocks is a really good product that's going to benefit children all over. Party in the Box, the same way. And American Cuckoo Clock, I just love Jody.
Mm.
But if I had to choose, I'd probably have to go with Spinny Blocks simply because it's just a single product at this point and it's not really mature. It's a little early.
I mean, they had a whole product line in mind, though.
That's true.
But what I was kind of worried about was this other business that that Pasco had. And not really being sure that they would go all in with the business. I mean, we're trying to get somebody who will go all in with money that we offer and to expand the business. And it was just really interesting to hear that it wasn't necessarily the ultimate thing that they would want to do. And then Kelly, his wife, like, I love that she was wanting to come out and be a part of the business a little bit more, which I think would be the right move. But I think of the three that are remaining, that's the one that I'm a little bit worried about.
Yeah, this is hard for me as well. Love the husband and wife team, love family, love what they've done. And I was actually thinking that they were going to be in the Final Four. Yesterday, you know, I would have probably said that they would have been one of my top picks because I just seen a great potential here in who they were. But after I asked them the question about the two businesses, and he agreed that he would let one of them go, and it wasn't like a strong, like, no, I'm not going to let this business go. That really changed my thinking. I still think he's going to do well, and they're going to do well, but because of that, I'm gonna have to say no at this point.
I think also, like, looking at the other products, the Cuckoo Clocks, Party in the Box, those are very unique products that you cannot copy because it's based on that person and their personality.
Yeah, that's a great point.
You know, and then the blocks, somebody had brought up that, like, you could just make that.
Mm. And there's a whole bunch of them on Amazon already. I mean,
right.
Not only could you make it, but they're already there. Like, the competition's,
I mean, you could
there.
Also argue that they have their books and that's intellectual property, right?
And I think that's a very smart thing. Yes,
yeah.
Absolutely.
But like you said, with the other people that are remaining and that we had already, you know, kind of seen him up against, is he the stronger one? Probably not. And for, you know, for those reasons, again,
it's hard though.
It is hard.
They all have really good stories though.
Yeah, that's true.
Like family, great military, stories. Like I think it's still going to do well.
Though. Yeah. Oh, I think they're going to be successful. And who knows, maybe season two. You know,
right. I mean, for me, it's same. I concur with you guys. I mean, stacking up against these other three,
it's tough.
Remaining companies, I'm already concerned about Party in a Box and American Cuckoo Clock. What's going to happen here with the others? It sounds like we're all in agreement with Spinnybox. They're all great companies, but I do think that the other two are stronger. The other two that are remaining. So I would eliminate Spinnybox here as well.
Yeah,
done deal. Spinnybox is out.
All right.
Thank you for joining us, Pasco, and congratulations on making it this far. We'll be right back after a quick word from our sponsor.
Being an e-commerce seller can be hard. Competition is tough, your friends don't quite understand what you do all day, and banks don't take you seriously. Well, you're about to get a break. Our friends at Payability provide sellers with fast, friction-free financing so you can buy the inventory that you need, get back to business, and keep living the life you want to live. Visit go.payability.com/pitch to get funded in as little as 24 hours and save up to $200. That's go.payability.com/pitch.
Now the judges have the tough task of choosing between American Cuckoo Clock and Party in a Box.
Pat, we'll throw it over to you. We got Party in a Box. I mean, Amanda's built this amazing company that's got amazing traction. Same thing with American Cuckoo Clocks. Talk a little bit about those two.
Do I have to pick one?
I know.
Well, I mean,
there's a few pros and cons of each.
I mean, I think for both, absolutely passionate. They have the raw talent to be sort of the front runner in that space, obviously. I think definitely for Amanda, there's more upside. You know, just the industry. Everybody's throwing parties. Not everybody's going to get a Cuckoo Clock. But it's very encouraged to hear Jody talk about kind of the unique angle that she has with the Ramones and the Sesame Street. Like there's, I don't know how I'm going to choose between the two. Right now I'm kind of leaning toward Amanda and Party in the Box. Although again, my concern earlier was the idea of just her wanting to stay at home and focusing on the subscription box or the box business. It worries me. Whereas the Cuckoo Clock, I think, is a little bit more, and she has the big team behind it that's already supporting her.
Does it bother you, though, that with Amanda's business, there's not really much of a building up a presence and building up, like, that social? Like, I think you could, but Cuckoo Clock lady really, yeah, Jody, but, you know, I think of her as Cuckoo. You're not Cuckoo. But I see her as being, like, I don't know, the company and the story, and she's got so much.
She definitely stands out more because it's a more unique product.
I love Amanda.
And she does have the potential to reinvigorate an old school industry, right?
Yeah.
She's an influencer in that space.
She is.
She did Sesame Street and the Ramones.
But as far as a business growth, who would have more potential?
Dollar-wise, I would have to say Party in the Box.
Amanda.
That's what I'm saying, you know? This is hard.
And it's funny, they both mentioned they want to focus on the smiles, right?
I know.
Yep.
I know.
Both focusing on making people happy. That's cool.
So to make things interesting here, let's who wants to advocate for American Cuckoo Clock?
I'll advocate for American Cuckoo Clock. Last round, I was fighting for Amanda hard, and I think I might have had to convince some of you guys vote her through.
Yeah,
I remember. And I was a big fan.
Yep.
But Jody today won me over. I would vote for American Cuckoo Clock over Party in a Box just because of the uniqueness, they're both so passionate, but I don't know, something about Jody and the Cuckoo Clocks and bringing back this age-old industry, and I won a Jungle Scout Cuckoo Clock. I mean,
all right, that's what it boils down to, isn't it?
All things considered, though, that's really tough to put these two up against each other, but my vote's for Jody and American Cuckoo Clock.
I'm sure Amanda could put on a Jungle Scout party for you, too.
Dang, she could probably
Jungle Scout party in a box.
Damn, I already voted for Jody, and I'm just hearing about this Jungle Scout party in a box now.
If I had to pick out of those two that I see the fastest growth, and I think more opportunities and not being, I guess, just in that one area, I would have to say Amanda with Party in the Box.
I like both of them equally, personality-wise. So
around here, we pick favorites.
So yeah, I don't need a cuckoo clock. Here's the thing. So I got to look at it from a business perspective for this one. And just in terms of pure dollar value, and the fact that cuckoo clocks are trending down, I think Jody has a good chance to reinvigorate that industry, but it's unclear whether you can get someone to buy a cuckoo clock just because LeBron has one, for example. So just for the business aspects alone, I'm going to go with Amanda.
Interesting. So that's three votes already for Amanda there.
You know, I live in a neighborhood that has a lot of kids, and I get invited to a lot of parties, and we throw a lot of parties. It's hard, and personally, I'd be willing to spend money to have a lot of that stuff done for me. I think that, to me, is a lot more marketable, and I love her taglines, like creating Pinterest-ready parties. Mm. Like, she has the marketing figured out.
Yeah.
It's already proven, and she's now in expansion mode, and it's going to scale up.
Yeah.
And I'm excited about that for business. I think Jody can still make an impact without the $50,000.
Yeah, I agree.
So I'm voting for Party in the Box.
I really wish that these two weren't in the same bracket. I think it's a shame because I really love the cuckoo clock concept coming into this. But Amanda won me over with her pitch, her second pitch. There was some stuff in her first pitch that I wasn't confident in, but after, you know, and I think that she picked up on that. So when she had a chance to do a second pitch, she outlined her business, her numbers. She knew everything off the top of her head. There was like really no question that she couldn't answer. So I'm buying into both the entrepreneur here and the business. I think without question, the business that can generate the biggest dollar signs is the Party in the Box. I think that even if the box concept doesn't necessarily work out, the business is going to benefit greatly from the prize money and from the mentorship in a way that I think is really exciting. So I have to go with Amanda.
Congratulations, Amanda. You're moving on to the live finals in Miami. After the deliberations, the judges wanted to personally let the finalists know they were advancing, so they called them back to give them the good news.
Hey, Kim.
Hi, guys. How are ya?
Pretty good. How are you doing?
I'm great, thank you.
So, hey, Kim, we just wanted to get back to you because we told you we'd let you know about the results tonight. It's been a really long day. We've had tons of different good companies, some that have just been amazing. So we just wanted to let you call and let you know that you made it to the final four.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I'm so happy, you guys. Thank you so much. Oh my God. My heart, I'm shaking. I can't thank you enough. I mean it from the bottom of my heart. I feel so lucky that I'm in this competition and I get to meet all of you. And I'm most excited to pick your brains and learn from you. So thank you for this amazing opportunity. I can't thank you enough, and I can't wait to call my mom and tell her. This is the best news ever. Thank you so much.
We can't wait to meet you either, and we'll see you in Miami.
Yes.
Yeah, we'll see you in Miami.
I can't wait.
Miami.
I'm taking May 17th off. Hopefully.
Congratulations.
We'll make this quick. I mean, we all loved you. We loved your passion. We loved your product. We loved your creativity. The fact that you're already a real business that generates significant revenue, and we think that you can totally blow everything up. We loved all your ideas. But unfortunately, the field was very strong. And you're one of the final four!
Yeah! There you go. Yeah. Final four.
Woo!
We will see you in Miami.
We will see you in Miami.
I will be there. I already have my ticket.
All right. Awesome.
Congratulations.
Well, hey, we're going to let you go to bed now. Go up and hug your kids and hug your husband, too.
I will bring him to Miami so you'll get to meet him in person.
Awesome. All right. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
As they were packing up, something wasn't sitting well with the judges. They realized there was one entrepreneur that needed to advance to the finals, even though they had been cut. The judges decided to reverse their decision and call to let that candidate know they would be joining the other four contestants in the finals.
Hey, Jody.
Hi. Oh, I didn't know you all were going to be there. Cool.
Yeah, we're all here. We are all going to be here. And I have to be honest, today has been a challenge for us. We were here since 8:30 this morning, and we've been in this room for a long time.
And
yeah, and you know, we actually were going through making all of these cuts, and it was hard. There was 8 contestants, including yourself. And to be honest with you, you had been eliminated, okay?
Okay.
But we actually were ready to leave for dinner, and we all loved you. Like, we loved your business. We loved everything about you. We loved your fire, your energy, your passion, everything. And we were literally ready to shut the set down, go to dinner, and it was the end of the day. And all of us were standing there in a circle having a conversation, and we said, we cannot leave. We have to do something different. We don't know how we're going to make it happen. We're going to have to make it happen. And we said, Jody's got to come back. We got to bring her back. So we decided, instead of 4, we're putting 5 people through. You're back in the game.
Made it to the final 5.
You made it to the final 5 now. The final 5.
And we'll see you in Miami.
So it's going to be tough, but we can't wait to see you.
I mean, it's great. This is just, it's amazing. I did not expect this experience to be like this. This is way beyond my expectations.
Are you excited for the final 5?
Oh, heavens yes. Thank you for getting me into this, because you're the first person way back when I was trying to figure everything out. What the heck am I going to do? And you're one of the people that was like a guru that I followed.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Well, that's why your business hasn't been as successful until now. But once
Okay, so congratulations once again. We'll see you in the finals.
Thank you so much. Have a great dinner. Tonight.
Congratulations, everyone. Next time on 5-Minute Pitch, we begin the live finals in Miami. We'll see you there.